Welcome to the King in Life program with Dr. Lawrence Kwagala.
Indeed, you're welcome. Hallelujah. It's a good morning. It's a wonderful day. It's a good Saturday. Praise the Lord, all listeners, and praise the Lord, those who are yet to tune in. And thank you for tuning in. This is Kingly Life, where we unveil Christ. Hallelujah. Welcome to the moment of truth. It's time to dine on the truth. Glory to God. I'm excited about what we're going to share today, you know. I'm expectant, you know. Praise the living God. Those who have tuned in on internet, thank you for tuning in. Those on your local stations, wherever you are, thank you for tuning in. God bless you. God bless you. Keep tuning in. And you may call your friend. You may be in a car. You may be at home. You may be elsewhere. You may be at your place of work right now. God bless you. Thank you for tuning in. It's going to be wonderful as it has been wonderful, you know. This is Lawrence Kwagala, as usual, at King Life program, unveiling Christ, unveiling the mystery, hallelujah, that was hidden but now is revealed, you know. Glory to God. Christ has been the real substance that the world has been searching for. Christ is the real substance that every humanity is searching for. The world is yearning to see. He's been that mystery that has been hidden. Praise the living God. Christ is the real substance why people and humanity strive and struggle in life, trying to get satisfaction, you know. But you see, all that was a mystery since the beginning. Even right now, at the time when the mystery is revealed, many are lost because they have not seen this mystery. They have not seen this treasure, you know, that the world, that humanity is searching for through his toilings and his labelings, you know. Praise the living God. And so God put his son as a mystery since the beginning. And so humanity has been searching, has been toiling, has been, all endeavors have been pointing us to Christ, who was a mystery. But praise the living God that right now the mystery is no longer a mystery, but it's normal, you know. The mystery has been revealed to us. That's why we are able to rest. That's why we are able to rest. Praise the living God. All the problems of the world is because of Christ. Let me repeat. All the problems of the world is because they have not embraced Christ. That's what I meant. Praise the living God. All the systems of the world are types and they are types, not shadows. They are types typifying the real mystery, the real substance, who is Christ. Let me say the governance, you know. He's the King of Kings. Everything, you know. People searching for money to get satisfaction. That's a type of Christ. As us who have known Christ as searching for him, are dining on him every day for satisfaction. Many have turned up being addicts of drugs, addicts of whatever mess you may say. All those are, they do it because they are searching for satisfaction. But you see, satisfaction is not gotten anywhere except in Christ. And so to them, Christ is the mystery. But was Christ has been revealed. Glory to God. And so we continue with our series entitled The New Creation Mystery. We are trying to unveil the mystery, the secrets, the hidden wisdom about the church, the hidden wisdom about the new creation. Glory to God. Liko Shikata Labaza. the hidden wisdom about the new creation. Hallelujah. The hidden wisdom about the new creation. Father, we bless you. We thank you. And I thank you for that. I thank you for that young lady who is actually expecting to learn today. Someone is eager. You are in your bed and you are eager waiting. You are even handling a pen. I mean, you can't wait. Hallelujah. God bless you. And so, Father, I thank you. I bless you for this wonderful moment. I bless you for this wonderful time. It's going to be wonderful. I pray for the eyes opening. I pray for them, for their eyes to be open. Whosoever's going to listen to me right now, Master, I believe and I know that his or her eyes are going to be open in the name of Jesus, because the words I speak are life and truth. The words I speak are life and truth. The words I speak are life and truth. And so they create life in their physical eyes. They create life in their spiritual eyes. And so both eyes are seeing right now. And so, Father, I bless you because their eyes are going to be open. In Jesus' name I pray. And so if you want to ask for my products, some of the products that are on market, a gift of righteousness, sin is a false giant, you are already righteous. Do not go prodigal, the love story. In him you are blameless. The new man of the new creation. There are many books. Glory to God. And Psalms by Dr. Lawrence. Psalms, you know. Hallelujah, glory to God. And many other products. Those are all books, praise the Lord. And other audio messages in series, are they run on air? Praise the living God. And so we continue with our mystery of the new creation mystery. Who is the new creation? And the Bible says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Glory to God. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. But I want to start with a question which I never answered last time. Somebody sent in a question and said, Doctor, does the Holy Spirit live when somebody sins? Before I continue to any other thing, glory to God. And so the question is, does the Holy Ghost leave you when you sin? The answer is, the Holy Spirit cannot leave you when you sin. Glory to God. I repeat, the Holy Spirit cannot leave you when you sin. Anyway, what is sin? Glory to God. The Holy Spirit cannot leave you when you sin. Those people who say that the Holy Spirit leaves you when you sin, they don't know the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Woo! But if you know the ministry of the Holy Spirit, you can't say such nonsense that the Holy Ghost can leave you when you sin. The Holy Spirit can't leave you if you sin. He cannot leave you. He cannot leave you. Praise the living God. Praise the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You see, he says, I'll not leave you helpless. I'll not leave you orphans. I'll not leave you lonely, but I will send you another comforter. Another comforter. Praise the living God. Another comforter. Praise the Holy Ghost. I will not leave you orphans. I will not leave you helpless. I will not leave you fatherless. I will not leave you comfortless. But I will send you another comforter. That another comforter means another comforter. Never said I'll leave you. He didn't say that I'll leave you. I'll send you a comforter. He says I will send you another comforter. That means another person who does the same role that I do. Allos paracletos, another comforter. There's the comforter doing the same thing that I do. Glory to God. So what was the ministry of Christ on earth? Praise the Holy Ghost. He was the man advocating for prostitutes. Neither do I condemn you. Go ye sin no more. Glory to God. That's the ministry of the Holy Ghost. To advocate for sinners. Another comforter. If the Holy Ghost only resides with us in good terms, that means he's not a comforter. And he's not a friend. But a friend is always with you in good times and in bad times. Glory to God. And see, if the Holy Ghost is with us in good times and bad times, that means he's with us all 24/7. Glory to God. He doesn't leave you when you do wrong. He does not leave you when you do right. He doesn't leave you when you do wrong. If the Holy Ghost leaves you when you do wrong, that means he's not a comforter. He didn't come to save us. Glory to God. That means salvation belongs to us. He only comes in when you're in good times. He only comes in when all things are bright. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But you see, for a long time, people have been educated in demons. People have been educated in wrong stuff, and they don't know the ministry of their the person that indwells them. That's why I was telling you that time that many are educated in the way demons operate. They are educated in the way how demons do things, but they are not educated in the way how the Holy Ghost does his things. They don't know the ministry of the Holy Spirit. The ministry of the Holy Spirit is to empower you, not to leave you. Sent us the Holy Spirit that when we are weak, the Holy Spirit comforts us. When you mess up, the Holy Spirit encourages you in that very mess. If the Holy Spirit leaves you when you do wrong, that means he's not your friend. A friend indeed, in a need, is a friend indeed. But you see, the Holy Ghost is more than a friend, your earthly friend. Glory to God. The Holy Spirit cannot leave you. He says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. He says, go into the whole world and preach the gospel. Teaching them and decide, you know, look. I am with you always. I am with you. He's with us through his spirit. Always. I know I tell people that the grace of God is too great to... I mean, when you are in a weakness, when you are in a struggle, that's when the grace of God is too strong. Through the Holy Spirit. Praise the living God. The problem problem is you only run out of the grace of God through your ignorance, but the grace of God through the Holy Ghost is always present with you. It's always present with you through the Holy Ghost. It is your ignorance that takes you out of the presence of God. But the presence of God doesn't go away from you. You are the one who go away from the presence of God through your ignorance. Your action cannot take you out of the presence of God. It is your ignorance. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so praise the living. That's a mystery. That's who we are, the new creature. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can text in on my telephone number 756-21-31-41. You can text in, please, and ask a question. If you want a prayer request, please, you can text in. And we communicate back. Praise the Lord. And so, yes, we are running a series of the new covenant, new creation mystery. We are trying to unveil the secrets, the hidden wisdom that God knows about the church. Praise the living God. The secrets that God knows about the church. You know, the new creation is the temple of the Holy Ghost. What does that mean? The new creation is the temple of the Holy Ghost. There is something I shared one time about another story called still about the new man. When I said that the new creation is part of the Trinity. But you see, blessed be the name of the Lord, that there is no time to explain that. The new creation is part of the Trinity. I mean, there's no time. You can inquire for my book, The New Man of the New Creation, or you can inquire for my my audio messages, a series of 7 parts. You can inquire for those audio messages, The New Man of the New Creation, to know in detail how the new man is part of the Trinity. Glory to God. The new man is part of the Trinity. The new man is part of the Trinity. The new man is part of God. The new man is God Himself. All those, I explained it in my book entitled The New Man of the New Creation, and in my audio message that the audio series I ran on in one time on air last year. You can inquire for those products. But what I can say is that the new man is part of God. The new man is part of the Trinity. The new man is inseparable from the Trinity. The new man, the Trinity cannot do without the new man, the Trinity is incomplete. Praise the Lord. Without the new man, without the church, Christ is incomplete. And you see, and that means the church, which is the new creation, is part of the Trinity. Praise the living God. That's why you say that I am the head, you are the body. We are the body of Christ, just to hint on it. Praise the Lord. If I am the body of Christ, that means I'm part of Christ. That means Christ is just the body. Christ is just the head. I am the body. And if Christ is part of the Trinity, that means I am part of the Trinity as the body of the Son. Glory to God. Glory. The mystery of the new creation. And so you realize that the new man is part of God. We are flesh of His flesh. You see? We are born of His bones. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. But you see, to inquire, to get a detailed explanation of that, you can inquire for my book, my message series, The New Man of the New Creation. It's also in a book, the same title, The New Man of the New Creation. You see, that is it. The new man is part of the Trinity. That's why the new man is not supposed to fall sick. If your body is if you are part of Christ's body, you are not meant to fall sick. Neither do you need a prayer. However, for the babes we pray. But you see, for a mature man in Christ, you are not supposed to fall sick, child of God. How can you fall sick when you are part of the Trinity? Honestly. Can you fall sick when you are part of the Trinity? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Just feel the anointing of the, you know. How can you fall sick when you are part of the Trinity? Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How can a child of God fall sick when he is a child part of the Trinity? You are the branch. Christ is a vine. The same substance of life. That flows from the vine, goes through the branches. That means the branches take on the nature of the vine because it gets its nutrients from the main vine. If you are the branches, child of God, And Christ is the vine. How can you fall sick? Woo! Hallelujah. Praise the living God. Thank you for your messages. You can keep texting in. Hallelujah. Prayer request. Prayer requests and questions, anything. Praise the Lord. Thank you for texting in, seeing your message. You can text me on 756-21-31-41. 756-21-31-41. And so, the Bible says that you are the branches. And Christ is the vine. And the very life that draws from the vine is the very life that goes into the branches. The life of prosperity. The life of divine health. The life of wisdom, the life of dominion, the life of righteousness, the life of holiness. Glory to God. The life of grace. This is how God perceives you, that you have the very life of God in you. This is a new creature. You know, for a long time you've been taught about curses. Curses, that the teaching of curses is below even ignorance level. Sorry to mention that. But it's unavoidable. The teachings of curses, the teaching of demons, you know, is below even ignorance level. It's not even a babyish teaching in Christianity, frankly speaking. The teachings of things following you are here. Bad luck, those things. I mean, it's below even ignorance level. I can't quantify which level. It's not even a babyish teaching. Because right now, what I'm trying to share is food for babies. Trying to come to your level of understanding. Praise the living God. I'm trying to tell you who you are. You see, for a long time we've sought for righteousness. You are already righteous. That is food for babies. But very many people can't believe that. Righteous is not a state of being. Righteous is a state of being, but not a state of doing. Righteous has nothing to do with your actions, apart from believing. That is babyish teaching, elementary Christianity. But you see, that's what is causing chaos in the church. Look at this. The nature of God is holy. And He calls you the branches. And He is the vine. What is your nature? If the vine is holy, child of God, come back home. You know, the problem, I mean, you know, there have been a lot of prodigal sons trying to preach the gospel. And so right now we are trying to preach the prodigal sons who are preachers to come back home so that they can preach the right gospel. You can't tell a prodigal son who is not yet back home to preach the gospel and you think will ever speak good about his father. Just imagine a prodigal son started to preach about the father. What would that prodigal son do if he had not come back home? I mean, what I'm trying to say is, if the prodigal son made an audience, created an altar, and started to preach before he came back home, what do you think he would preach? He would preach an angry God who is not forgiving. He would preach an angry, but you see, it would have been his ignorance that making him to speak that, but otherwise, the father is at peace with him in his heart, and eagerly waiting for the son to come back home. Praise the living God. So for a long time we've had the prodigal sons preaching the gospel. And so they have preached another gospel. They have perverted the gospel. Praise the living God. But now we come in to change everything. You see, God calls you his divine. And he relates you with him as vine and a branch. What does that mean? The same nature of the vine is the same nature of the branch. If the vine is holy, what is you, the branch, child of God? I pray your eyes get open. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. Praise the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. Praise God, my left eye is hurting me. And I'm badly in need of a good house. A good housemate. Please pray with me. Father, I bless you. And I thank you for this wonderful child of you. Oh, son or daughter. And she may be a daughter. Praise the living God. You who are sending this message, touch your eye right now. And your eye has already healed. I want you to testify before I leave this air that your eye, I speak that pain right now. I command that pain to leave. I command that pain in the left eye to go. Pain, leave. Heal right now. Heal. Right now, left eye. Glory to God. Heal right now. And may you get a good housemaid. All good things belong to you. You're gonna get her. Praise the Lord. And your eye is healed. Text in. Text in. Text in. Text in to testify. Praise the living God. You see, you understand? That's what I was telling you. He calls himself a vine, and you are the branch. And he says the vine is righteous, that is Christ. And the vine is holy, that is Christ. Who are you? He says, my life is your life. Colossians 3:3, you know? That means if Christ's life is my life, and Christ is my life, Christ's life is a holy life. That means I partook of the holy life. That means I'm not seeking to be holy. I am holy. I am not seeking to be righteous. I am righteous because that is my nature. Oh God. What I'm sharing is elementary truth. Trying to come to your level to get you to the mountain top. Praise the living God. Praise the Holy Ghost. Glory to the living God. Oh my man. Lima koshi kata la bakosite. Libo koshi kate le brozanta la makoshitaya. Kate le brozinda la makoshete le kositaya. Lima koshete le brokoshitaya. The mystery. The new creation mystery. These are the secrets that you ought to know about yourself. You know, theology without the understanding of the new creation is incomplete theology. Theology without understanding of the new creation is incomplete theology. Because the new creation is part of the God. Theology without understanding of the new creation is incomplete theology. It's not theology. Praise the living God. Theology is not the study of the law of Moses. That's not theology at all. Theology is not the study of principles gotten from the Bible. That's not theology at all. Praise the living God. Theology is the study of life. Study of the way. Study of God kind of life. Is you can't study life without the study of the new creation. The new creation is the Son of God. Oh God. And so it's unavoidable. When you want to study about the Son of God, you can't fail to study about yourself as the Son of God. Because you are part of the Son of God. You are part of God the Son. He says in 1 John that as he is, he says as he is, so are you in this world. Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Thank you for texting in. You know, many are texting in. Somebody has texted in and says, wow, thank you for that wonderful message. I'm already blessed. I'm really blessed. Glory to God. Get to know it. You know, for a long time, prodigal sons and daughters of God have taken in the place of preachers, and they have preached contrary. Let me tell you, child of God, I don't mind how long you've preached. This thing is not about your experience. It's about the word. It's not about the experience. It's about the word. You don't need to work out these things. You need to believe these things so that they can work out in you. Like I told you, sin is not a. I don't want to talk about even sin right now, because it's not. I'm not supposed to make a new man aware of sin, because the new man knows no sin. The new man came after the. The new man is a product of forgiveness. So the new man is not seeking for forgiveness. The new man is already. The new man is not the man that was forgiven. I'm not even worthy to say that the new man is already forgiven. The new man wasn't forgiven. He's not the man that was forgiven. He's not the man that God died for. God never died for the church. He died for the sinners. So church, child of God, wherever you are, I mean the Anglican, I mean the Pentecostals, I mean the Baptist, I mean the Methodist, I mean wherever you are, I'm not a Pentecostal, me who is preaching right now. I'm not a Baptist. I'm not. I am a child of God. So wherever you are, worship God of the Bible. And so you are the new creature if you are. So you may be praying from an Anglican sect. God bless you. You may be praying from a Pentecostal sect. God bless you. You may be praying in a Methodist. God bless you, wherever you are. What I'm trying to say, that if you really truly believe in God, you're a new creature. You are as holy and righteous as Jesus is. Because that's what the Bible says. Holy people are not found in Pentecostals only. Woo! Holy people are not found in Bazukufu. I hear Bazukufu. That's a statement in Uganda here. You may be in a, praise the living God. Holy people are the new creations, the church. So if you truly believe that you are a child of God and you are born of God, believe what I'm telling you, you will live. You will live. For the words I speak are life. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You see, you can text in. 7, 5, 6, 21, 31 and 41. You can text in, please. And I'm seeing many messages are coming in. Please, you can text in. You can text in, please. 7, 5, 6, 21, 31 and 41. I want to pray for someone who is sick right now. And someone in need of finances. First, now, I want to pray for someone who has a physical infirmity in his body or her body right now. I command you to rise up and walk. I command you to rise up and walk. I command your eyes to see. I command your ears to hear. I command your mouth to speak. I command your legs to walk. I command those crippled legs to walk, to function normally by the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, I command you to heal right now. Heal. Heal right now. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I pray for miracle man. 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 By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I command money to appear on your account. I command money to appear on your account, in your pocket, on your account, in your pocket, in your, on your account. Libo zata kata lava zeke lima sete lebrosa. Someone to call you right now and give you money. Miracle money. This is the life we ought to live. You believe it, you take it. It's dead. It's done. Praise the living God. You see, God calls you his child, his son. He says, you have not been born of an incorruptible seed. You've been born with an incorruptible seed. Yes, seed that bore you is incorruptible. What does that mean, child of God, to you about your nature as a new creation? That you were not born with a corruptible seed, but you've been born with an incorruptible seed. The seed that bore you is incorruptible. The seed that bore you is incorruptible. What does that mean, honestly, to you, child of God? Who are you in terms of nature? The seed that bore you is incorruptible. Glory to God. Child of God, get to know this. What's your nature? The seed that bore you, the seed of God, is a seed of holiness. What is your nature? The seed that bore you is a seed that is righteous. The seed of God. What is your nature? Child of God, what I'm sharing is elementary Christianity. So if it sounds mature to you, just know that you are below elementary. But blessed be the name of the Lord, now you are coming up to the mountain top. You are sowing on high in wisdom and understanding. Praise the living God. What I'm sharing is elementary Christianity. And it is what is affecting the clergies of the church. For a long time that you've been told that to work for holiness. I've come to tell you, you ought not to work for holiness. Believe before you work. You know, for the Bible says that work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Read the scripture completely. Read it very well. He says, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Comma. The second verse says, for. That means for doesn't begin a sentence. For is a continuation of the previous sentence. It says, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God both at work, it is God at work in you both to will and to do. Believe, and God will work in you both to will and to do. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's wonderful. Glory to God. You know, people are texting in. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, he says that the seed that bore you is incorruptible. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. I mean, you know, you parents outside there, you give birth to your children, and this child has this temperament. 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 But do you know what parents normally do? They say, this child is this and this because his mother is this and this. Which is a right thing. Messages are coming in. God bless you. Keep texting in. Going to tackle your messages. Praise the living God. You see, he says, this child is this and this because his dad is this and this and this. Which is true, because it was the daddy's seed that bore that child. And so by default, by nature, that child is like that because of the daddy's seed. The daddy's sperma, spermatozoa. Praise the living God. And so you find it so, you find it hard that it's almost impossible to change someone's temperament or nature or way of behavior because of unless the gospel has come in and defined the nature. You know, it's only the gospel that can come and defy the nature of the temperament of someone. But you see, if you use human standards, it is impossible to change the nature of such a child, because he got it from his child. He didn't decide to be born that way. Someone decided to bear him that way. He's a slow learner, he will slow learn that way. He's a quick learner, he will learn quickly. You have nothing to do with it. Reason being, it is the seed of someone that gave birth to that progeny or offspring. Praise the living God. Now God says, you are born of me, born of my seed. Man, just imagine the seed of God, the sperma of God bearing you. What is your nature? It is ignorance that makes you suffer, child of God. I mean, honestly, let the Spirit open your eyes. That's how far you can explain. Praise the living God. That's a new creation mystery. Stop becoming righteous and stop becoming holy. Believe and then act wise. Good morning, Papa. I'm Herbert Kitoti. Is it bad to take little wine for our health? What does it mean when God says it is not what goes inside us which makes us unclean? Glory to God. But what comes out of us? Praise the living God. Good morning, Papa. I'm Herbert Kitoti. Yes, Herbert, thank you for your message. And this is the same message? Let me read the scripture. Morning, Papa. I'm Herbert Kitoti. Is it bad to take a little one and for our health? And what does it mean when God said it? Said it is not what goes inside us which makes us unclean, but what comes out of us. yes, Herbert. It's not bad to take little wine. It's not bad to take little wine. It's not bad to take little wine. That means taking wine isn't a sin. But the problem is you getting out of your mind. That's where the problem comes in. Taking wine isn't evil. But the excess of it is what the problem, that's where the problem comes in. When it becomes excess and takes over your mind, that's where the problem comes in. Praise the living God. I think I've answered you. So that means the best option is to avoid it, to avoid further damage if you can't handle it. Because what I know, I think, and I know it's true, Timothy was a mature Christian. So he could handle stuff. But if you know you are not, please, praise the living God. But this self-taking it isn't a problem, isn't sin. Praise the living God. You said, what does it mean when God said it is not what goes inside us which makes us unclean? That's very true. What goes inside us doesn't make us unclean. What goes inside us doesn't make us unclean. It's kind of, I think this needs some kind of to get scriptures and explain it. Praise the Lord. And so we've answered that taking little wine isn't sin. But if you want to have, the end result of excess of it is what the problem comes in. That's where the problem comes in, you know. Praise the living God. That's where the problem comes in. And this last part of the question, can you allow me in the last few minutes, I'll come back to it when I get this very scripture, with these very scriptures. There's something I want to build from that. Pastor, I'm called Kakumi Zenwe from Entebbe. Pastor, I need to pray for me, for my family, friends, and I myself, and your results, which will be resided soon. May the glory of God be with your messages. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor, I'm called Kakumi Henry from Entebbe. Pastor, I need to pray for my family, friends, I myself, and your results, which will be resided soon. Anyway, results, I don't know. Whatever you need, Henry, I grant it in Jesus' name. Whatever you need, I grant it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And may the glory of God be with your messages. Hallelujah. Thank you for that. Thanks, Pastor, for the great work of your of your Father. Wow, glory to God. You see, testimonies are coming in. Thanks, Pastor, for the great work of your Father that you are doing. I'm Miriam. Last week, when you prayed, Pastor, I received the miracle cash of grace in my MTN account. Continue praying for me to get school fees. May God bless you. Glory to God. Thank you, Miriam, for such a wonderful testimony. You see, this is what we normally tell you, that this life is effortless. You don't need to fast to manifest God. Measure the fact fasting is good. You don't need to. This thing is effortless. It's a grace of God at work in us. Thank you, Maria. And continue praying for me to get school fees. Father, in the name of Jesus, you who provided miracle money to Miriam last week when I prayed. Miriam is getting miracle school fees. 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 Miriam, you're receiving it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Someone has sent a message. Wow, thank you. Thank you. Our God is not a God of food and drinks, but He has made everything clean for us to enjoy. That's very true. Thank you. Thank you, brother. The one who one time asked, do you fast and something like that? Thank you very much. Messages are many. I'm trying to pick which one that I should urgently answer. That's why I'm kind of pausing, you know. But I'm grateful for the this is Hubbard again, and he says, thanks a lot, Papa. I'm Hubbard still again. I like your preaching because you teach the real gospel of Christ. You taught me about grace, Lord. You taught me about grace, Lord, tithing, and I'm now understanding the Bible. And thanks for the answering my question now. Thank you for your great appreciation. God bless you. Thank you for appreciation. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You see, praise the Lord. Yeah, we still have some time, and please, the last bit of Hubbard, please allow me, next time I'll start with that last bit. You know, I don't want to rush, but, you know, that last bit. Thank you, Hubbard, for appreciating this good Miriam, miracle man. And you see, great things are happening. And so if you get healed when I pray for you, please testify. This is a life of grace, whereby the Holy Ghost is operative in us. Grace means God at work in humanity. The Lord means man at work by himself. Grace means God at work in humanity. I want to pray for somebody right now. Again. You who want to receive healing, be healed. And I want to pray for my partners wherever they are. I want to pray for my partners of Kingly Life. Pray for my partners, Kingly Life. God bless you. School of Revelation. God bless you. Truth Camp Meetings. God bless you. And missions. God bless you. Thank you for being part and a parcel of this gospel. Hallelujah. Thank you for being part of this. May God abundantly multiply you May God abundantly multiply you. And I speak with a satisfied heart that it's gonna happen. That you will reap more than and exceedingly beyond what you think. That's what the grace of God means. That you reap beyond what you sow. You are not gonna reap what you have sown. You're going to reap beyond what you have sown. That's what the grace of God does. I'll not point you to your works, my partner. God bless you. You're blessed. You're gonna reap beyond your soul. That's what the grace of God does. Abundantly more than what you think or imagine. It's gonna happen. And you're gonna see miracles, wonders happen in your life, in your finances, in your health, in your families, in your relationships, in your ministries, wherever you are. I'll pray for you. I love you so much. You are the reason why I'm speaking this. You are the reason. You are the people behind scenes. God bless you. I love you. I cherish you. I love you. Words can't explain this, but I love you so much. I love you so much. I bless you. I bless you. I bless you. As a man of God, I bless you. I bless you. I bless you. I bless you. And I say, I bless you. 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 If you want to be part of this ministry in partnership, that's the financial partnership, please you can contact me, and I give you the telephone number on this very number, 756-21-31-41. 756-21-31-41.